Hey friends, welcome back. In today's video, I will be trying Vizcom, which is an AI tool that transforms your sketches into renders and even crazier into 3D models in seconds. So let's try this out. Here's the website. This is free, by the way, but they also have pro account options. Today, I will be using the free version. You need to sign in and it creates you a workspace where you can also add team members. Let's click on create new file. Then you will have this page. As you can see, there are some tools here and on the right where you can write prompts. You can, for example, describe the colors, materials of the project you want. You can choose here a style and add a reference image. And then you can choose the influence. This is for adjusting how much the AI should consider your drawing when creating the rendered image. Then you have the button generate. On the top, you have some tools for drawing like brush, eraser, colors, shapes, etc. And here you can find the tools that transform your image into a 3D model. Let's try by drawing a basic chair. So you can import a drawing you made and took a picture of it, or you can directly draw here in the website. That's what I will try first. Okay, this is hard. Don't laugh at me. I'm literally trying to draw with my finger on the pad. It's the first time I try this, and let me tell you, it's not easy. It's getting worse and worse. It seems that I just can't draw straight. Anyway, I will leave it here. Let's write a prompt that describes the chair I want. Or we can also click on describe. Simple line drawing of a chair with a cushioned seat and backrest, slightly angled legs. Okay, nice. I will just delete the simple line drawing part. And I am surprised, it described it well actually. I don't know what to choose as style, so I will leave it like that. Then generate. As I left the influence at 100%, it kept the form of my drawing really precisely. But I think if I change the influence here of the drawing and make it lower like that, it would be more accurate. So that's what I have for 20%. It kept the perspective and the overall shape. I think this is actually really great if we don't really have a precise idea and that we need to brainstorm. Let's try some other chairs now. This time I will draw on paper, then import it. I'm roughly sketching different famous chairs I found on the internet. And now I will import them one by one. So the first one, I clicked on describe. Armchairs with cushions, tufted backrest, angular armrest, swivel base, minimalist design. Okay, great. The influence is 75%. Oh, and I will add a color to the prompt, like green. Then generate. And here's the result. Okay, not bad at all. We can save the render by clicking on this arrow down here. I would just delete the word green to see what color it would choose by itself. Oh, great. Nice. I like it better, actually. Okay, next chair. When I click on describe, it gives me round chair with curved backrest, four legs and no armrest, simplified line design with visible seat and back support. I will just add yellow color. And that's the result. I think we can do better. I will add soft and cozy. Okay, better. But I will change the prompt. Yes, I prefer this one. So we need to keep playing with the prompt and influence until we get what we want. Next chair, modern chair with a tufted cushion and curved legs featuring a minimalist and elegant design. Generate. Not bad. Let's try a different color. Okay, that's classy. I'm wondering what it will give me if I change the influence to 30%. I actually love this one, really, really nice. Next chair. Yes, really basic. Next chair, plus armchair with tufted backrest, rounded armrest and four short legs. This is so cute, I love it. Let's try a different color. Really nice, actually. Let's try the different palettes. This one is called Cyber Cell. Technicolor is 6. And Pastel Render. Volume Render also. Feel free to play with the settings and experience different styles, prompt and influence. Okay, next chair. I don't really have hope for this one. Minimalist chair with a curved backrest and forelegs, simple design. I will just delete the side view and add red. I'm actually surprised. Interesting choice of material. I kinda like it. It just doesn't look comfortable, but with some adjustment it could be nice. I wonder what it will give me if I put the influence at 25%. Yeah, it makes sense. Still not comfortable though. Anyway, let's try now the 3D model tool. After you've added the render to the layers panel, click on the icon and click on Generate 3D Standard. That's amazing. I can't believe it. I wasn't expecting this. Okay, let's try the others. Look at that. I'm really impressed. This can help designers in so many ways. Apparently, it can even create more detailed model in the pro version. But even this is amazing. So that's all for this video. I'm honestly impressed. Let me know what you think and which one was your favorite chair. If you still have time, here are some other AI tool reviews and see you in the next video. Bye!